into depth. Like we will learn what is gene, what is allele, what is trait, what is monohybrid cross, what is dihybrid cross, monohybrid, dihybrid cross. We will come across many terminologies. Terminology like dominant trait, recessive trait, okay, heterozygous, homozygous, all those we will see today. Okay? Yeah. Let us see what is a chromosome. Let us see the structure of chromosome and then we will discuss what is a chromosome and what does it consist of. Okay.
Chromosomes
are 23 pairs. Among that, we have 22 pairs as autosomes and one pair as allosomes. What do you mean by autosome? What do you mean by allosome? Yeah. Allosomes are those which help in heredity. These are the ones which help in heredity. Maybe the X chromosome or Y chromosome are called as allosomes, which help in heredity. These will contribute for the passing of genetic information from one generation to other generation. Okay, autosomes do not contribute. These are the germline cells I have told, right? These only allosomes undergo meiosis, whereas autosomes undergo mitosis. Clear about this? Genes, what are genes? Yeah. Now, what is genome? The complete DNA of an organism, which is present in 46 chromosomes. The entire DNA of any organism is called its genome. The complete DNA or the entire DNA of an organism is called as genome. Okay, now we have 46 chromosomes. All the genes and genetic content present inside those 46 chromosomes make a genome of an organism. Okay, all the genetic material present inside the organism is called as genome. Okay, this is called genome. Clear what is genome? Okay, maybe the genome will be small, the genome size will be small, the genome size will be big. Okay, depending upon the organism, the genome size varies. Okay, clear? And next we'll see what is homozygous, heterozygous, dominant, recessive, what is the allele, what is the trait, we'll see in the next slide. Okay, now let me explain all this terminology using a cross. Okay, now we'll do a cross. I'm taking height of a plant as a character and we'll see what happens. Now I'm crossing the pure line parents. These are the parents. I'm telling these two are pure lines. What do you mean by pure lines? Yeah, they which have two alleles which are similar, maybe dominant or maybe recessive. They will be similar. Here, capital T are similar, right? They code for tall. And here, small T codes for dwarf. Okay, they should be similar and should not be heterozygous. They should be homozygous only. Okay. Now, let us take this gametes. We have two gametes. And here also. You know, right, gamete should be inside a circle. All the gametes should be inside a circle. Now, let me make it in a square. This is for female, this is for male. So, I'll write here capital T male and small t. Okay? Here, capital T, small t. Capital T, small t. Capital T, small t. Capital T, small t. What is the phenotypic ratio here?
Tall.
Phenotypic ratio is all are heterozygous tall, right? All are heterozygous tall. So, it is 4:0. Right? Genotypic ratio is also same. 4:0. So all the offsprings are tall here. Heterozygous tall. Clear? Now here let us see what is homozygous, what is heterozygous. Here both the parents are homozygous. They have same alleles. They have similar alleles. See? Homozygous. Example, parents. Both the parents have similar alleles. capital T, capital T, or small t. So that is homozygous. Okay. Now what is heterozygous? They will have two different alleles. You can see the different alleles in the offsprings, F1 generation offsprings. So these are F1 generation offsprings, right? So they all have two different alleles. They are heterozygous. If you have two different alleles, then that is heterozygous. Okay, here what is heterozygous? Now, what is dominant? Dominant is nothing but the one which express its character. It will suppress the character of the other allele. Now we have capital T and small t. Here, though we have small t, is that character shown here? Can we see the dwarf trait? No, we can't see. We can see only tall, right? Because the capital T is dominating the small t. It is dominating the small t and expressing its character. That is why it's dominant, right? It is suppressing the character of dwarfness, right? So small t is not expressing its character. So it is suppressing the character. T is dominating it. Capital T is dominating and small t character is suppressing. So we call this capital T as dominant trait. Okay, that is dominant. And recessive. Okay, dominant we can see here also. This is the dominant parent. We have got the dominant characters here from the dominant parents. Recessive is the one which is suppressed. Small t as recessive. So dominant can be capital T, small t also. Is homozygous dominant? Is heterozygous dominant? Because we are here it is expressing the dominant character only. Capital T is the tall character which is dominant. So it, as it is expressing the character tallness, it is a dominant trait. Here also it is expressing tall, it is heterozygous dominant. Capital T and small t. Now we will see what is recessive. Recessive is small t from this cross. Okay, because it is the character of recessive trait, that is dwarfness. Okay, that is about. Now we have covered homozygous, heterozygous, dominant and recessive. Okay, clear now? Clear? Do you have any doubts in the terminology? You don't have, right? In dominant you will have homozygous dominant and heterozygous dominant. But in recessive you will have only one. You don't have homozygous and heterozygous here. Okay, clear? Now you are clear what is gene? What is chromosome? Genome? Allele? Okay, allele is a different forms of a gene. The definition of allele is, these are the different forms of a gene. Different forms of a gene which bring variation in the offspring. Now, did you understand the definition? Different forms of a gene which bring variations in the offspring. So, now we have a gene called as hide. It has two alleles, capital T and small t. From these two alleles, if we get both the gametes as capital T, then we are getting tall character. If we get capital T, small t, then also we are getting heterozygous dominant tall character. If we get only small t, then it is a character for dwarf. Because of the alleles only we are getting change in the offsprings, right? I told that brings variation in the offspring. What is bringing variation in the offspring? The alleles, the contribution of alleles is making difference in the offsprings, right? Due to this capital T or small t only we are getting variations in the offspring, either tall or dwarf, any other characters also. When we take any other characters, you will see when we go to different crosses, due to the alleles only we will get variation. So that is the definition of allele, different forms of the gene which bring variation in the offspring. Clear? That is the definition of allele. Okay. Now you are clear with all the terminology. Now let's see the history of Mendel. Gregor Johann Mendel. Okay. He is the father of modern genetics. Gregor Johann Mendel is the father of modern genetics. Okay, what do you know about modern genetics? You know, genetics is a branch of biology which deals with all these variation, heredity, all this. But what is modern genetics? Yeah, all these crossbreeding, hybridization, genetic engineering, all these comes under modern genetics. So he is the father of modern genetics, and he was a physician. He used to teach physics. Okay. Okay. Then he had interest in crossbreeding, hybridization, all these techniques. He was doing hybridization and crossbreeding in honeybees. Then he got interest in plants. He was doing crossbreeding in honeybees first. Then he got interest in crossbreeding in plants also. Then he started crossbreeding and hybridization in pea plant. Okay, he started with pea plant. Okay, he was an Austrian monk also. He used to work as a priest. Okay, he used to work as a priest. Okay, that is about some history and introduction about Mendel. So he started hybridization in pea plant. So what is the scientific name of pea plant? You all have studied in your school, right? What is the scientific name of pea plant? Physum sativa. Physum sativa. So underline it separately. Capital P should be there, and here it should be small only. What are these?
That's the
this is genus.
That's the genus and
species.
This is the genus
and species.
This is the species. Always the genus name should start with a capital letter, and species name should start with a small letter, and we should underline them separately when you write a scientific name. Okay. Yeah. Now that is the introduction about Mendel. I told he chose the pea plant, Physum sativa, as his plant of interest. Okay. Why did he choose only a pea plant? Why he chose only the pea plant?
Easily available.
Yeah. The
short life.
The characters why he chose only pea plant is it is an annual plant. You know what is annual, diurnal plant, perennial plant? You know, right? What is annual, diurnal, perennial plant? He can cultivate many generations of the plants in short lifespan. That is why he chose pea plant. And pea plant is having many contrasting characters. Pea plant is having many contrasting characters. When I tell contrasting characters, what is contrasting characters?
Flower.
You should have two different characters or two different alleles that can be seen in the plant. Okay, two different contrasting means it should be contrasting. It should be different from opposite. Contrasting means opposite, right? So there are seven different contrasting characters which Mendel chose in the pea plant. What are the seven different contrasting characters? Let me just note down. Write it down here. Character, dominant, allele, and right. Okay, first one is flower color. Flower color. Dominant is purple and recessive is white. Height of a plant.
Tall.
Plant height. Tall and dwarf. Tall is the dominant character and dwarf is the recessive character. Next, position of a flower.
Axial or
position of flower. Axial terminal.
Why is axial terminal?
Yeah. See, when you take a plant, so this is a plant, then two plants, just take it. If the position of the flower is here, the position of the flower is here, then it is axial. If the position of the flower is here, then it is terminal. Okay, the position of the flower is here, then it is axial. If it is a terminal portion, then it is terminal. Okay, clear what is axial and terminal? Clear, right? Okay, now that is the position of the flower. And next is the seed shape. The dominant is round and the recessive is wrinkled. And next is seed color. Yellow,
green
is dominant, green is recessive. And pod color. What do you mean by pod? Which covers all the seeds. When you take a pea plant, you have something like this, two openings, and in between you have all the seeds here, which covers the both all the seeds inside it, which covers the both sides. That is the pod, right? This is present like this, and inside that we have seeds, right? So that is the pod. What is the pod color?
Green.
Green is dominant. And yellow is recessive. So just you are confused between seed color and pod color. You will tell seed green is dominant here. No, in seed color, yellow is dominant and recessive is green. When you take pod color, green is the dominant and yellow is the recessive. Please don't get confused here. Always you get confused here, okay? And next is pod shape. Next is pod shape. What is pod shape? What is the dominant trait for pod? Flat. Flat and inflated. One is flat, other is inflated. Okay, these are the seven different characters. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These are the seven contrasting characters that are present in the bee plant. That is, we have many contrasting characters, right? When you take hibiscus, do you have these many contrasting characters? You don't have. Take any other examples. You don't have these many contrasting characters. So, we thought this would be the best plant to choose for his experiment. Okay, so it is an annual plant. It has contrasting characters. Next is pollination. Pollination. Pea plant is basically self-pollinating plant. It is self-pollinating plant. But we can do cross-pollination also. Cross-pollination is also possible in the pea plant. Okay. Cross-pollination is also possible. possible. Cross pollination is also possible. So there is one more interesting character about the bee plant. Though it is a self-pollinating plant, cross pollination is also possible. That is why he also choose bee plant. And next is, it is easily available. It is easily available plant. It can be grown in any conditions and it can be grown in any kind of soil. Okay, it is easily available and easy to cultivate also. Easily available and easy to grow or cultivate. Easy to cultivate. That is, these are the five reasons why he chose a pea plant. Okay, clear? This is the reason why he has chosen the pea plant. Clear with the reasons? You understood all the things till now? Okay, next. Next we'll go to different laws of Mendel. Mendel have formulated certain rules and regulations and laws for his genetics or for his contribution towards genetics. There are three laws. Those are contributed by Mendel to genetics. In the three laws, the first law is law of dominance, the second law is law of segregation, the third law is the law of independent assortment. We will see each. Now, sometimes in the exam, they will not mention law of dominance. They will just ask first law. So you should know it in the order only. First law is law of dominance, second law is law of segregation, and third law is law of independent assortment. So you should know it in the order also. They may ask you just first law. What is first law of Mendel? What is second law of Mendel? So just be clear with the names also. So first is law of dominance. Okay. Or first Mendel's first law. So I'll explain this with the help of a cross again, that it can be easily understood. We'll take the same character. Okay. What does this law of dominance mean? Law of dominance states that when you take a pure parent, pure line parent, always the first generation will be dominant. When you take pure line parents, in the first generation of the cross, always you get dominant trait, a dominant character. That is the law of dominance. So here the parents are pure line. There is no combination or heterozygous traits here. Both the parents here, capital D and small d. So both the parents are pure line. In Mendelian genetics, always we start a cross with pure lines. Pure line cross. Parents will be pure. Okay. What is a pure line? P-U-R-E. On the time the parents are pure. Okay. It is not heterozygous. Always it is homozygous. Okay. So we started with a cross where the parents are pure line and we have got the gametes. So we get two gametes here. But as the two gametes are same, I have indicated only one.